Good morning, children. Today we'll discuss the new chapter that is called oscillation. First of all, we'll discuss in this chapter what is periodic motion. What is periodic motion? Periodic motion, when a particle repeats itself in regular interval of time. Then motion is called periodic. Example, here is the sun and earth is moving around the sun. After certain interval, earth again comes at the same position. Around the sun, earth is moving. After certain interval, earth again reaches at the same position. So the motion of earth is called periodic. It can be also demonstrated mathematically, because in mathematics there are some periodic function like y equal to sin t. This is a periodic function. Y, displacement. In a mathematics, y is a variable, sine function, and theta angle. When earth comes back at the same position, angle made by the earth is 2 pi. So we can add 2 pi sine theta plus 2 pi. Again, you are knowing that sine 2 pi plus theta equal to sine theta. Again, same functions each obtained. So the motion of earth can be represented by y equal to sin theta. It is a periodic function in mathematics, but this function can be used to demonstrate the motion of earth. So the motion of earth can be represented by y equal to sin theta, because after certain interval again same function is obtained. So the motion of earth can be represented by y equal to sin theta. Okay, now come to the oscillatory motion. Oscillatory motion, a type of motion in which particle repeats itself in a regular interval of time. In regular interval of time, but moves to and fro. Regular interval of time, but moves to and fro. To and fro, forward, backward. There is a condition, to and fro. But the same condition as periodic motion, in periodic motion also, particle moves in a regular interval of time. Here also, particle moves in regular interval of time, but condition is that particle should be moved to and fro. Like example, simple pendulum. Simple pendulum. Simple pendulum. This motion is called periodic. This motion is called periodic. Also called periodic, it is oscillatory motion because it moves to and fro. It is oscillatory motion. And this oscillatory motion is also called periodic because it covers distance in equal interval of time. So this motion can be represented as y equal to sine theta. Y equal to sine theta. Then how it can be demonstrated, this function, how it can be demonstrated in a certain equation, we'll see. Circular motion. And oscillatory motion. This oscillatory motion is also called simple harmonic motion. This oscillatory motion is also called simple harmonic motion. This oscillatory motion is also called simple harmonic motion. When the displacement, angular displacement will be minimum, not very large, then it is called simple harmonic motion. So see, this is a circular motion. This is the x-axis. This is the y-axis. Here is the particle at this position, initially at t equal to 0. The initial position of the particle, this is called, generally denoted by phi, initial position. And this phi is called initial fields. Initial fields. Now, the particle moves through the some angle that is called theta. Means particle goes at P dash position. This is the origin O. If you take, draw the perpendicular here, this is M. If you take this angle, sine theta plus phi, sine theta plus phi is equal to perpendicular by base, perpendicular is P1M, base is OM, perpendicular sine theta, perpendicular by hypotenuse, OP1. P1M, if its coordinate will be X, Y, then this is the y coordinate and this is the x coordinate. So we can write here sine theta plus phi is equal to P1m that is y, OP1 that is equal to r. So we can write here y equal to r sine theta plus phi. We can write here y equal to r sine. You are knowing omega is equal to omega equal to theta by 2, omega that is the angular velocity, then theta can be represented as omega e plus phi, omega t plus phi, not phi, phi, because here is phi. Now, this is the standard equation of oscillatory motion or simple harmonic motion, where y is the displacement in time t, means particle goes from p to p1 in time t, or maximum amplitude, this is the maximum amplitude, this is called displacement, maximum amplitude, that is also called displacement, sine function, omega angular velocity and phi initial phase. So this is the standard equation of simple harmonic motion or oscillatory motion. So this is the standard equation. This standard equation can be used for simple harmonic motion. It is also periodic. I think clear. Now, we'll see how we recognize the motion is oscillatory. Sorry, motion is simple harmonic or periodic. See the one question. There is a question, sine theta plus cos theta. Sine theta plus cos theta. Question is that, is it in simple harmonic motion, periodic motion? So yes, we'll suppose here, let y equal to sine theta plus cos theta. This can be written as y equal to 1 by root 2 sin theta plus root 2 cos theta. It can be written. Then y equal to 1 by root 2. This root 2 can be written as cos 45 degree into sin theta plus this can be written as Here I write down 1 by root 2. Here also 1 by root 2. Then here will be a root 2. Then this will be equal to then cos 45 plus this will be equal to sin 45 into cos theta. Then this can be written as root 2 sin, this will be theta plus 45. This is equal to y. Our standard equation of simple harmonic motion, y equal to r sine omega t plus phi. It corresponds to this equation. So this motion is, this equation represents simple harmonic motion. Any equation represents simple harmonic motion, that will be also periodic motion. Because any periodic motion is in simple harmonic motion. So now it is clear. You can see, you can take any example, mathematical example, and you can prove it, either it is periodic or simple harmonic motion. I think clear. Now come displacement, velocity and acceleration. Displacement, velocity and acceleration in SHM. Displacement, velocity and acceleration in SHM. You are knowing displacement as displacement y equal to आर साइन ओमेगा टी प्लस फाइव. डिफरेंशिएटिंग विथ रेस्पेक्ट टू टी, डिफरेंशिएटिंग विथ रेस्पेक्ट टू टी, देन दिस विल बी इक्वल टू डीवाई बाई डी टी, डी बाई डी टी, डी बाई डी टी आर साइन ओमेगा टी प्लस फाइव. Then this dy by dt will be equal to velocity. R will be common. This d sine omega t plus phi divided by dt. This can be written as v differentiating cos omega t plus phi. Again, this will be differentiated. Omega t, t differentiation 1, omega, and phi, the differentiation of phi will be 0. So this velocity will be equal to r omega cos omega t plus phi. This is the equation for velocity. Again, we differentiate and we get the acceleration. Again, differentiate. Again, differentiating dv by dt, dv by dt is equal to d by dt r omega cos omega t plus 5. This will be equal to dv by dt acceleration. R omega will be common because it is a constant term. D cos omega t plus 5, omega t plus 5 divided by dt. Then this will be equal to A r omega cos theta, that will be equal to minus sine omega t plus 5 multiplied by omega, differentiating. Then we can get here, A equal to r omega minus r omega square sine omega t plus 5. This is the equation of acceleration. So we got the equation for displacement, velocity, and acceleration. Now, how it can be represented? In graphical form? So, graphical representation. Graphical representation. Our equations are y equal to r sine omega t plus 5. We are taking let phi equal to 0, initial phase is 0. Then this can be written as y equal to r sine omega t. Then v will be equal to r omega cos omega t. Then a will be equal to minus r omega square sine omega t. Now we can represent it. This is the y. This is the velocity. And this is the acceleration. This direction will be t. This is the position, different positions. This is the wave you have read in class 5. This is called 0. This is called t by 2. This is called t. This is called half time period. Again, you will take half. This will be t by 4. This will be equal to 3t by 4. So we can keep it in 0. This is t by 4. This is t by 2. This is 3t by 4. Okay? Now, here is 0. So put here 0 in time 0. Sin 0, 0. So this will be the position. Again, we take here t by 4. Omega equal to 2 pi by t. 2 pi by t into t by 4. This will be cancelled. Pi by 2 means sin 90. Sin 90. This will be equal to sin 90. Maximum. Again, we put here t by 2. So omega 2 pi by t. 2 pi by t. 2 pi by t into, this is t by 2, t by 2, then this 2 will be cancelled, t will be cancelled, pi, so sin pi will be equal to 0, so this will be equal to 0. In this way, it moves. Now here velocity, if you take here t equal to 0, cos 0, 1, so this will be equal to, here, maximum. That will be equal to r omega. Again, here we take here, that is equal to t by 4, t by 4, then that will become pi by 2. So, cos pi by 2, cos pi by 2 will be 0. Again here, take theta, again here t by 2, when you will take t by 2, that will be pi. Cos pi will be equal to minus 1. So, this will become minus 1. So in this way, velocity graph will go. Now acceleration, will take here 0, sin 0, 0. Then this will be equal to 2 pi by t. Again we take here t by 4, t by 2, 4 then pi by 2, sin pi by 2, 1. Sin pi by 2, 1. So sin pi by 2, 1, but here negative. So it will come negative sign, minus, this will be minus r omega square, minus r omega square. Again we take here t by 2, t by 2, then this will be pi, sin pi 0. So this will come here 0. So in this way we can draw the graph of displacement, velocity and acceleration. I think clear? So from this part, theoretical question will be asked, how you represent any simple harmonic motion in standard equation form, derive the velocity, displacement, velocity and acceleration graph, and then how will you represent in a graphical position. You should indicate and problems based on it. Okay? Thank you.